Hi guys, so today's question is subsets and problem. You are given some non-negative numbers in the form of an array or a set and a sum. You have to check whether there is a subset possible among these numbers so that the sum equals to this. Let's see, for this case there are 4 elements in our array and the subset 8 and 2 will sum to 10. So this question over here will return true. What if it was 16 over here, the sum was supposed to be 16, then it would not have been possible and the answer would have been false. One thing to note over here is we have to find a subset. In subset, the elements don't have to be continuous. So 8 and 5 is a subset. Only 4 is also a subset. 4 and 8 is also a subset. We have to consider all the possibilities over here. Also note that we cannot repeat the numbers. Say if we had to sum to 16, then we could have just added 2, 2, 2, 2 again and again, right? And we would have got the sum 16. So this is a very good point that we should discuss with the interviewer, check in our problem, that we cannot repeat the numbers since we have to find a subset out of this, right? What is the brute force solution that comes to our mind? Let's find all the subsets possible and check whether the sum is there or not. If it is there, we'll just return true. Otherwise, in the end, we'll return false, right? Let's check this approach. So suppose there are n elements in our array. There will be two possibilities for each of the elements, whether to include that element or not include that element, right? So two possibilities for each of the n elements means 2 power n subsets. So this approach is not very efficient since it's 2 power n. But if you still want to apply this, let's check how we can apply it recursively. Let's go through all the subproblems over here. Let's start with the last element 5. There are two possibilities whether to include this element or not include this element. If we decide to include the element, then our subarray will be 8 to 4, but our sum will be 10 minus 5, which is 5, since we have included this number 5. But if we exclude the element from our subset, then our array will be 8 to 4. But since we are not including this, the sum will still remain 10. So as you can see, we have divided this problem into two subproblems. For sum 5 and sum 10. Again, we can divide this into two subproblems for including 4 or not including 4. Similarly, over here, to include 4 or not to include 4. So you will notice that each of the subproblem over here can be divided into two subproblems. And there are n elements. So if we draw the entire thing, it will be of height n. So yes, they were 2 power n subproblems, right? So this will be the recursive approach to solve this problem. But again, this is not at all efficient. So what is the better approach to solve this question? As we can see, we divided the question into sub-problems. So yeah, we can do it using dynamic programming. Let's see how. As you can see, I have formed a 2D matrix or a grid over here to form our dynamic programming solution. I know the first question that comes to our mind is, what are these numbers, right? So these are the elements that were given to us, 8, 2, 4, 5, and we had to find the sum 10. Now, how will we know that we are supposed to write all the numbers from 0 to 10 on this side? That is a very good question. So if you notice the sub-problems that we discussed earlier, we were reducing the sum if we were including the values, right? So the sub-problems were reducing to sum. So if we included the number 5, the sum reduced from 10 to 5. Similarly, if we had included the number 4 first, the sum would have reduced from 10 to 6. So we have to consider sub-problems for sum from 0 to 10. Now another question is, why from 0? Because in our question it is given to us that all of these numbers will be non-negative. If that is not given to us, we cannot use this approach. Obviously, because then the sum can be negative as well. Then we cannot start making our dynamic programming solution from 0. But it is given to us in our question that the numbers will be non-negative. In an interview, if it is not given to you that these numbers are non-negative, it is a very good question to ask because this shows that you are thinking about all the possibilities. And sometimes interviews purposely give you half information to check whether you are thinking of the edge cases or not. So what does this matrix actually denote? Each box over here is a sub-problem. Let's see how. This box over here is a sub-problem of numbers 8 and 2 and sum 5. This box over here is of subproblem of numbers 8, 2 and 4 and sum 9. So this box over here will give us our final answer. Let's go through all of these subproblems one by one and see if we can come up with a general solution for dynamic programming. let's start with initial conditions. So what if the sum is zero? I'm considering this column over here right now. If the sum is zero, it doesn't matter. We can just exclude all of these elements and the answer will always be true. If we have to find the sum zero, we don't need any of the elements. So they don't matter. The answer will always be true. So this is our first initial condition. If this matrix is capital M, M of I 0 is always true if I am using I to traverse the rows and J to traverse the column. So we have the initial condition for our first column. But what about the initial condition for our first row? There are two ways we can handle this. One is to add an extra row, or we have done in our previous videos. That will denote the sub problem of not including any of these elements and taking an empty subset. So in that case, only the first element will return true and rest all of them will be false. Because from an empty subset, you can just get the sum of 0 and rest all the elements will be false. But there's another way to do it. To save the space, I'm going to be using that way. If we had only this row, it means that we have only one number in our array, that is number 8. So what all sums can we actually get if we have only number 8? That is 8 only, right? So if we have number 2 over here, we would have added 2 over here, because that is the only possible solution we can have. It is not like we can include 2 again and again, so 2, 4, 6, 8 will be true. It will all be false because we can include these numbers only once. So only when the sum is equal to this number over here, the first number that we are considering, the answer will be true and it will be false for rest of the cases. I hope that makes sense. So what is the initial condition for the row? If the sum is equal, if J, so I am considering this J since these numbers will be equal to the number that we are using for traversing. So if J is equal to input of I, then the answer will be true. So matrix of IJ will be true, else it will be false. Since we have the initial conditions now, let's get started and fill the rest of the grid and come up with an algorithm for that. So let's start with our first box. This denotes the subproblem of numbers 8 and 2 and to find the sum 1. So first thing to consider over here is that the sum is actually lesser than this number. We are at this row, right? So we'll be considering this number. Since this number is actually greater than the sum, it really cannot contribute to the sum, right? So there is no way we are going to include this to get the value of 1. So we can just exclude it and get the value. So if we do not include the 2, what was the answer of finding the sum 1? It was false. So our answer will also be false, right? So this is our first case. That is, if J is less than input of I. We are using J to traverse and this itself denotes the sum that we are considering in that subproblem, right? If J is less than input of I, then M of IJ will be M of I minus 1J. Since that number cannot contribute to the answer, we will just get the value of from top. That is, we'll exclude this number and check what was the answer, right? So we got the value from top. If it is not clear, don't worry, it will be clearer when we go ahead. Let's consider this subproblem now. The subproblem is of the numbers 8 and 2 and the sum is 2, right? Again, there are two possibilities over here, whether to exclude the 2 or to include the 2. Let's consider both of them one by one, how we did in our proof for solution. So if we decide to exclude this 2 and it won't contribute to our sum at all, then we can just get the value from top how we did previously, because this 2 is not going to be included. So we can just get the value from top, right? So without this 2 and for this sum, what was the answer? The answer was false. So else there are two cases. When we exclude that number, it will be M of I minus 1J, similar to our first case. Or, so one of the two cases has to be true. If we include the value 2, then we have to reduce the sum. So how did we do? If this 2 contributes to the answer, then we have to just reduce the sum by 2 and our new sum will be 0. And we have included this 2 already. So now we have to consider a subproblem of having just number 8 and finding the sum 0. Basically, we are going one row up and going back two steps and considering this sub problem now, 8 and 0. Since this is true, this will be true. So our second condition is m of I minus 1 and j minus input of I. Don't worry if it is not clear now, it will be clearer. What are we doing over here is, we are including this number. Since we are including this number, we are reducing the sum. Since this number was 2, we are going back 2 steps and considering the sub problem that without this 2 and for the sum 0, what was the answer? That will be the answer over here, right? If it's not clear, don't worry, we will be filling the rest of the grid. We already have our algorithm now. Considering the next sub problem now, we still have the numbers 8 and 2 and we have to consider the sum 3. If we decide to exclude this 2, then we can just get the value from top, that is m of I minus 1j, that is false. So we go one row up and reduce the sum by 2. So that is, we are going to include this 2 now. Even if we include this 2, then we have to consider the sub problem of having number 8 and the sum as 1, since we are going back 2 steps. This is also false and this is also false, so our final answer will be false. For this sub problem, again, if we exclude the 2, this is the value. If we include the value 2, then we have to go back 2 steps. That is this sub problem, this, that is false. Over here also, this is false. 2 values back, this is also false, so false. For this sub problem also, this is false. We go back 2 values, this is also false, so this will be false. So it does not matter whether we include this 2 or not. There is no way we can get the sums 3, 4, 5 or 6. You can just check 8, 2 if we had to get the sum 6, right? So if we exclude this 2, then we have to consider the subproblem of getting 6 with just having 8. Obviously that is not possible, so 6. So this is the subproblem. But if we include the 2, we go back 2 steps and reduce the sum by 4. Is it possible to get the sum 4 with having just 8? No. So again, that will be false. Similarly, this will be false since this is also false, and we go back 2 steps, this is also false. We come here now. Now since the value on top is true, we really don't need to check the other case and this will be true. If any of the two conditions is true, then it is true, right? So what does this mean over here? That means that we are excluding the value 2 and we are able to get the sum of 8 by having just 8. Since that was true, this will be true. That makes sense. Again, this will be false. Why? Since this is also false and 2 steps back, this is also false. So this will be false. Let's check for the sum 10 now. If we exclude 2, then we cannot get the answer since this is false. But if we include 2, the sum will reduce from 10 to 8. 10 minus 1 minus 2. So this is true. So this will be true. This sub problem means that we can get the sum 10 including both 8 and 2 since we are getting the value from here. That makes sense. Let's come to this box now. We have come to our first case again. Because this number, that is input of I, is less than the sum, that is j. Since these values are less than this, this value cannot contribute to our sum. Obviously, right? 4 cannot contribute to having sum small 2 or 3. So our answers for these three boxes will come from top. So without this number, what were the answers? So we'll just get the answers from top. That is false, true and false. Let's come to this problem. 1, 2, 3, 4. Since this is true, this means it is true. Why? Because if we include the value 4, then our sum that we have to consider is 4 minus 4, that is 0. And we have to consider the subproblem of 8 and 2 and the sum of 0. Let's see. So now we have the numbers 8, 2 and 4 and the sum needed is 4 itself. So if we exclude the 4, we cannot get the sum of 4 from 8 and 2. But if we include that 4, then our sum will reduce to 0 and that is possible to get by taking an empty sum set. Coming to this subproblem now, again excluding the value 4 will give you false. Let's include the value and check 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, this is also false. So this will be false only. Either this or that had to be true for this to be true. But we cannot find the answer. So now let's come over here. So without this 4, we cannot get the sum 6. Let's check whether we can get the sum 6 including this 4. So if we had to include the 4, we have to go back the sum with 4 steps. That is 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh yes, so this value is true. So here the value will be true. Why is that? Let's see. So sub problem is of 8 to 4 and we have to get the sum 6. So if we include the value 4, then our sum will reduce to 2, and that is the sub problem that we considered, right? Having the numbers 8 and 2 and the sum 2, since this value is true, this will be true, and that makes sense. Let's come over here. Here, without this 4, we cannot get the answer. Including the 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, again we cannot get the answer, so it will be false. Over here, we can get the answer without including the 4 itself, so this will be true. Over here, without the 4, we cannot get the answer. Including the 4, let's check 1, 2, 3, 4. Again, we cannot get the answer, so it is false. In this case, to get the sum 10, we were getting without this 4 itself, so we can just take the value from top and this value will be true, right? Let's come to this box now. We are in the first condition. What was that? If this number is less than the sum that we have to calculate, obviously it cannot contribute. So we just get the values from top. That is, without the number 5, what were the answers? We'll just get that from the top. So over here it is false, true, false, true. That is till when this number was less than the sum. Over here it is equal, so we have to consider both the cases. So over here, if we exclude 5, the answer was false. If we include 5, let's check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The answer was true, and that makes sense, because if you remove 5 from the sum, then we are considering the case of having numbers 8 to 4 and the sum as 0. That is true. So this will be true. Over here, without including the 5 itself, we were getting the sum 6. So we can just get the value from top. That is true. Over here, without this 5, we are getting false. So let's try including 5 and check 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, we are getting the value true. And that makes sense again. Why? Because we can get the sum of 7 by including the values 5 and 2. And yeah, that makes sense because we got this value from top. So yeah, we included 2 and we got the value. Let's come over here. Again, without this 5 itself, we were getting the sum 8. So we can just write true. In this case, without including the 5, we are not getting the sum. So let's go back 5 steps and check. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, we can get the sum 4 with the numbers 8, 2 and 4. So our answer will be true. In this case, we can just get the value from top. So our final answer is true. This is our algorithm and it works for this example. I recommend you to take more examples and try this out. If someone asks you what are the numbers that we have to include to get the sum 10, then we can just check over here. Since we are getting the value from top, that means that we are not including this 5 at all. So we can just get over here. Again, we are getting the value from top. So we don't have to include 4 again. But this value we did not get from top. That meant that we included 2. So 2 is in our answer. Then we go back 2 steps. And this value we got from top. So we have to include 8 again. So 8 and 2 is our final answer to get the sum 10. So we will have to backtrace to check which are elements to include to get this sum. What is the optimization that we could do in this question? So if you just had to check whether there is a solution or not and not find the exact solution, just return true or false. There is a very good space optimization possible. Let's check how. Over here, to form this row, all the values that we needed were from one row up, right? We were checking either the value directly on top or we were going back some values. But either ways, we were taking the values from I minus 1 only. So we really don't need the values on top of that. So for this row also, we just needed one row on top. For this also, we just needed one row on top. So when the number of elements given in our array are like too big, we can do a space optimization and keep only two rows over here instead of keeping all the rows. I've discussed optimization in my previous videos also. Let me know if you need me to dry run them. I hope you have understood the question. Please leave your comments below. And please do like, share and subscribe. It will mean a lot to me. Thank you.